that's getting people to do tshuva, almost like Haman. Haman made people do tshuva. You know that, right? Haman made people do tshuva.
That's why his grandkids became big rabbis.
Paro made people do tshuva. Why did Hashem not kill Paro? Aside from the fact that he removed his free will, is because Paro made people do tshuva. The suffering that he put on Am Yisrael got people to do tshuva. Haman almost killed all of Am Yisrael, but because he got all of them so scared that they did tshuva, he got the benefit that some of his descendants became Talmidei Chachamim in Bnei Brak. They teach Torah, became big Rabbanim. Zera Amalek became big Rabbanim, Tzadikim. Why? He got Am Yisrael to do tshuva. Now Irma, she doesn't have Olam Haba. Irma is just a storm, it's a wind. But Irma is also in the Torah. Irma is also in the Torah. If you remember, a few weeks ago, we talked about Gematria. Gematria is the way that you actually use the letters of the Hebrew alphabet to figure out different secrets within the Torah by adding the numerical value of each letter. You see that there's different things that are connected. So the Mishnah says Gematria ze parperaot lechokhma. It's like a seasoning. It's a seasoning for wisdom. So we see that there's different things in the Torah that are connected simply by seeing that their numerical value is coincidentally the same. It's not coincidence, obviously. So Irma has a few places in the Torah. I'm only going to mention a few. There's, I don't know, probably 500 of them. But I'm going to mention three of them. Irma, the storm, that some newscaster made up the name. Hashem, when he created the world, he already knew this newscaster is going to make the name. Or this weathercaster is going to make a name, Irma. But it was written in the Torah. This is just to show you divine intellect. So Irma, the way you write Irma in Hebrew is Aleph, Yud, Resh, Mem, Hey. Aleph, Yud, Resh, Mem, Hey. Numerical value, 256. Numerical value, 256. Aleph, 1. Yud, 10, it's 11. Resh, 200, 211. Mem, 40. 251. Hey, 5. 256. Tzedar? Go with the math? Passed. Good. Okay, first. In the book of Amos Tzaddik. Amos the prophet. Amos used to be a prophet. The book of Amos, in chapter 9, verse 8, it says, Hinei, hinei, Adonai Elohim b'mamlecha achata, v'yishmalti yota me'al pnei ha'adama, efes ki lo eshmid eshmid, ashmed eshmid, et bet Yaakov ne'um Adonai. It says, behold, the eyes of the Lord Hashem are upon the sinful kingdom, and I will destroy it from upon the face of the earth. But I will not totally destroy the house of Jacob, the word of Hashem. So Hashem Yitbarach is telling the prophet Amos, tell the people that the sinners, I'm going to destroy them, the goyim, the idol worshipping, I'm going to destroy them. The people that are wicked, I'm going to destroy them. But even sometimes you can have wicked people that are Jews. One thing I made as a promise to Avraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov is that even when I destroy the wicked, Jews and non-Jews, with the Jews, I promise it's not going to be all of them. I'm always going to keep them. But with the non-Jews, I don't have that promise. I don't have that deal. So, from the word Adonai Elohim b'mamlecha achata'a, specifically those four words that says Lord Hashem upon the sinful kingdom. Those four words in Hebrew, about a half a dozen words in English. Total value of those four words, Hashem, God, is upon the sinful kingdom, numerical value, 256. Irma. So here Hashem is telling us he's sending Irma to the Goyim. He's not sending to hurt the Jews. He wants the Goyim to do tshuva also. Next. Book of Daniel, chapter 2, verse 47. ענה מלאכה לדניאל ואמר מן קשות די על האחון הוא אלה על העין ומראה מלכין וגלה רזין די יחלת למגלה רזה דנה. So here it says the king exclaimed to Daniel and said, in truth I know that your God is the God over all gods, Lord of kings and the revealer of secrets, since you are able to reveal this secret. So Nebuchadnezzar, who was the king of the world at the time, was a wicked person, but he had some dreams, and Hashem gave him a prophecy of what's going to happen at the end of days. And no one was able to translate this prophecy, except Daniel. So Nebuchadnezzar says, I know that your God is the God of all gods. I know your God is Emet, because you're the only one that was able to translate the dream. You're the only one that knew what was going on. And I didn't even tell you anything. It's not like I gave you hints and you figured it out. You knew things even though I tried steering you the wrong way. Meaning that your information that you got had to come from God. Your God is the God of all gods. It's the real God. Everything else is nonsense. So in this verse, where it says, Elachon u ela alayim, your God is the God of all gods, numerical value, Irma, 256. Meaning this Irma is coming from God. Which God? The God of all gods. Shemit Barach.
What does it say the word soft, though?
256. Might as well say the word. Numerical value. Next, last but not least, Book of Psalms, King David, chapter 143, verse 10. למדני לעשות רצונך כי אתה אלוהי רוחך טובה, תנחני בארץ מישור. King David says to Hashem Yitbarach, teach me to do your will, for you are my God. May your good spirit guide me over a level ground. Ruchacha tova means good spirit, but it also means good wind, good storm. Rucha tova, numerical value, 256. Irma. So there's also something good that could come out of Irma. On one end, we learned from the first one, where is it coming from? It's coming from God. Which God? The only God that's real. At the end of it, we know that the second thing is we learn that it's here to punish some people, unfortunately. Some people that are going against Hashem. This is just a reality of life. You go against Hashem, Hashem has to get you to pay the bill at some point. It's just a reality of life. You can't continue going against Hashem forever thinking you're just gonna have free coast forever. You're going to live till 120, you're going to be a multimillionaire, you're going to go to Olam Haba and enjoy Gan Eden. Not going to happen. So first and foremost, it comes from God. Second of all, punishment also comes from God. Last but not least, if you're a good Jew, if you're a good Gentile, don't worry, it's a good win for you. Why? You won't be affected. You're fine. That's Irma in the Torah.